care if the whole place burned down. Good morning and welcome to Sunup on 7. My name is Ranta Samuels Khan.
Good morning, everybody. I'm Kevin Mendez. Welcome to your Friday episode of Sunup on 7. And I always say it, es viernes, el cuerpo lo sabe. I know that you know it as well. It's a long weekend awaiting.
Yes!
So today we're going to start right on Sunup on 7.
People are feeling excited for the weekend. People are getting ready for La Ruta Maya. Mm. People are just ready for a relaxation, whatever it is. We're here for you, and of course, we're continuously celebrating Women's Month and all the excitement that comes with it, because there's a lot that happens, you know, in Women's Month too as well. So,
yes,
a lot to happen. One of the things in that same accordance will be a Women's International Women's Day Expo coming up very soon, and we get to talk about what that expo entails, how you need to support the ladypreneurs, and all the good stuff. Anything else, Kavita?
No, we're gonna leave it right there.
We're gonna leave it. Oh, yeah, just drop the mic.
Yes.
All right, all right. Oh, no problem at all. But stay tuned, guys. We have exciting conversations. Somebody tell me, Wally Birdie, Kevin and me want to maybe knit something. I don't know. We'll see how that work out. But stay tuned for all that. So much more. Put your comments in the comment section and we're here for you. Let's make it lively, interactive, fun, juicy, and respectful as always.
As
shall we get
always.
To
the desk?
The heat check.
My beautiful people, welcome to Sunup on 7. It's Friday and we want to thank you so much for making some company to Rena tonight. Let's start with today's show by having a look at the weather according to the Belize Met Service.
Good morning. Mainly fair, warm and dry weather will continue over Belize and coastal waters today and tomorrow. The 24-hour forecast is for mostly sunny skies today and partly cloudy skies tonight. No rain is expected. Winds over the open sea will be from the east to southeast at 10 to 20 knots, and the seas will be choppy. Maximum temperatures today will be around 88 degrees Fahrenheit along the coast, 94 inland, but only 82 degrees up in the mountains. The outlook for Saturday and Saturday night is for continuing mainly fair, warm, and dry weather. There is a high tide at 9:05 this morning, a low at 2:22 this afternoon, another high 8:43 tonight, and another low at 3:40 tomorrow morning. Sunrise this morning is at 6:05 and sunset this evening is at 6:01. The moon will set at 4:31 this afternoon and rise again at 5:37 tomorrow morning. In the fire risk forecast, the risk for forest and brush fires is moderate for today, so be careful when lighting fires. In the sargassum update, impacts from sargassum are expected to be minimal to moderate during the next few days. With that, we end this report from the Belize Weather Bureau.
And that is our weather.
That's our weather update. Easter weather is here, which is absolute love. But of course, you know, you gotta stay hydrated. If there's anything, drink your water and respect forest fires. It's very, very important.
And I'll try to start your fire on your own, too, unless you know how to manage it too
that
as
is
well.
True.
Remember, the. I believe the Belize Zoo was giving some helpful tips. You can go and message them too as well. If you want to learn about the ways in which, the times in which you should be not starting fires or when you should be starting fires, because I know there's a certain period of time where people like started and then I wonder when it could like sit ablaze and get rampant a lot easier than when you start at a specific time. So, you know, check out them on how you should be getting about with your fire management. Kevita, how you feeling this morning, boo?
I'm feeling good. It's good to be back here on the show. I feel like I have been disconnected for a bit, you know. I have to think, what will happen the day I leave Sunup on 7?
Not sure. It's like
it's just this interaction that I miss. You know, I look forward to coming up and sharing this space.
I'm trying to be taller here.
Yeah, I do feel a certain way about being in this space. We're missing out on
the outfits. I don't know why. I feel like just...
We're missing out on the outfits, right? That's what
you're
I'm saying.
You're missing out on outfit. Kev's like, I need people to see my outfit,
we
Renata.
Need our outfits.
Our outfits.
Our outfits, because like, we work on this.
Yeah, we're together on this, right? But you know what, boo? I like the fact that I could like be gang.
It's good. So I just want to like big up Gilvano for doing an amazing job. If you're looking at what's at the front, I'm just going to give you a little history. Those are the old like gauges from the Libertad sugar factory. So look at that, Gilvano just finding relics all over
amazing.
The place. And you know, and
he
making
just,
it
when it
a
comes
signature.
To authentic.
Yeah,
things,
yeah.
He will do it and he will really, really just show up. I have to give a big up to Brent too as well, because Brent was one of the big organizers for the heat check tour, so we're going to talk later about Kev's experience, guys. That should be very fun. I'm really looking forward to hearing that conversation. Met Kev give me the 411 as my baby, but they in an orange walk, they sweat.
I was. Literally was. Also, today is March 8th, which is International Women's Day, and mm-hmm. the theme for this year is Invest in Women, Accelerate Programs. However, this year's main theme campaign is... inspire inclusion. So we want to big up all women, you know, that are worthy of celebrating this year. You know, the main campaign for this year is addressing economic disempowerment of women.
Exactly.
However, there are other pressing issues that are getting addressed, which is, for instance, the sexual reproductive rights of women as it regards to a very controversial topic, which is the right over your body as it regards to like how many kids you should have, if you should have any kids, you know, especially as it regards to abortion rights. So it's very big what's happening, you know, in the scene. However, today we want to big up and celebrate all women today, as it's International Women's Day.
Yes, big up to all of you guys. It's not, I remember speaking for a speech on how International Women's Day too as well. And one of the questions they asked you is like, is it hard to be a woman? And I was like, yes, it really is hard to be a woman. I think they said it in the Barbie movie too as well. All the things that we have to do that are very controversial, that have to go against mm-hmm. each other. And I'm just like, we really, really want to just big up every single woman out there that is trying every day. I want to ask you that, remember that you don't always have to be strong. Give yourself grace to be weak, to feel, to hurt, to move on, to grow, to heal from every single thing. Like, there's so much untold stories and struggles that women go through, and they just hold that great front up because work have to get done.
Yeah.
Pick the need to get fed. All of this needs to happen. So I don't got time to feel this sometimes. I just need to move. So I just want to extend all the love to all the amazing women out there. We see you, we love you, we appreciate you. Continue to do your thing, Boozilla.
That's true. And yeah. Just as we move on, talking about International Women's Day, if you're thinking what to wear on this Friday as you want to commemorate and celebrate women on International Women's Day, there are three colors that you can use, and one of them is purple, which represents justice and dignity. The other one is green, which symbolizes hope. And the other one is white, although a contentious concept, it signifies purity. So three colors you can go about using today: purple, green, or
white.
That's what
I get ready right now. Purple, green, white. Thank
or
you so
white,
much
yes.
for that, Kevito.
Of course, you know, I'm always doing background research.
Aww,
and today is also
to
Ruta Maya, so we're going to big up Brandon, who's out there. We have some pictures of him.
Yes,
already
out there already. He may don't get interviewed too already. Like,
I know.
Yesterday when they may get ready for practice, Brandon shoot out. Fire, gang, we can get the power bank and say like, woo, we need to go. So I'm praying and giving you all the best of luck and wishes and sending all the love to you, Brandon. You and your team, life happy live.
Life happy live. We wish you all the best. To everybody that's competing in Ruta Maya, I want to wish you a safe journey.
Yes.
Have an enjoyable one. Come out with memories, because I'm sure there's going to be a lot of those.
Definitely. Yeah. I want to also say that for people out there reminding you, please not throw your garbage pan the ground. When you go out there, go watch La Ruta Maya. I am begging you. Man, I really like this thing. I am begging you, do not throw your garbage out there. The whole point of La Ruta Maya is to actually talk about conservation and preserving, you know, our forestry and all these different things. So please, I'm not going to throw, you know, whatever on the drink, whatever on the eater, so out there, guys. Let's respect that, the nature, Mother Nature, and everything that it stands
that
for.
That is true. That is true. All right, so let's, that with that, is a perfect segue into our first Couch Talk topic. And there is an accident that we have to report. And this is an accident that involved the Belize Defense Force, and particularly four persons that are part of their Ruta Maya service team. So between 3 p.m. yesterday, as they were going on their way, mile 34 and 35 on the Jar Price Highway, the driver lost control of their vehicle, and so it caused it to flip. However, their four soldiers were involved, which they had varying degrees of injuries. However,
hopefully no loss of lives.
So we're just thankful that there was no lives lost in this situation. Yes. I'm sure it was scary. However, and also what we can report about the situation is that the paddling team for the BDF, they're fine, and they're going to be participating in this year's race.
They're going to still be going on. If you're wondering who those officers are, what those BDF soldiers are, it's 35-year-old Nigel Rivas, 29-year-old Jamie Castellon, 24-year-old Oscar Barahona, and 32-year-old Bruce Graham. So they're all part of the support team, and we know that they're not going to be out there because, of course, the injuries and everything. But the BDF team will continue to push forward. I'm praying the best for them too as well, because hopefully somebody can do that filling for support team. Because when we spoke with Mr. Bradley, and Brandon talked about it too as well, how important it is to have a good support team out there. Like, we only see the players on the canoes going and everything.
Yeah.
But, you know, having a support team in those pit stops to make sure you get hydrated, make sure you eat the correct thing, all of that, really does help you to continue on those races. So hoping they get that support. And guys, looking forward to seeing their participation in La Ruta Maya 2024.
We move on to our next Couch Talk topic. And this is coming from a press release coming from our friends for conservation and development. So they have recently flagged that they're on their survey of the area, they found a new road that has been put in the Chickabole National Park. And this is a road that extends about 1.4 kilometers into the southern region of the Chickabole. So this starts at Dolores Petén. And what's suspected for the use of this road is as a water road for cattle ranching that's in the area. So this is like an alarming situation. And they were like, this was not in our most recent survey. So this is definitely new. As we know, the Chickabole is quite permeable and you know, it's susceptible to many things like poaching, it's susceptible to deforestation. And now there you're seeing that it's also being used for water resources for their ranching that's happening.
I believe this is so unfortunate. Big up to the Friends for Conservation and Development for being able to flag this, because what they were saying, they caught this in their aerial view. They did not see that before. So you know how quick people they start and make this thing? Like, literally, I got check the other day. I come back, check, the thing don't start getting made. But it's great to see how they can flag that, and you know that helps with patrols in this area. As you know, it's a vast area that Chickabole really stretch and extend to as well. So it's good to be able to see them see this and see how they can be able to maneuver it and get the support to make sure that we can prevent the cattle ranching in any way, or the access to the waters and everything to us all, because we have to protect our Chickabole. Like, it really provides water for us too as well, and there's so much other benefits to the Chickabole. So I really want us to be able to man that ship, and big up to the Friends of Conservation and Development for flagging that and catching that early on too as well. And we move into our third couch topic. Ay, 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 ay. So you know what the fun part is? Brandon and I had a lot of fun yesterday when we were going over just the what happened with heat check, what happened with elections, municipal elections on Wednesday. And one thing we talked about is just the sweep out, the sea of blue that happened when it came to municipal elections on Wednesday. As we know that UDP only had two seats initially before the elections, and now they have upped the ante to now six seats. Now, the leader of the opposition, Shine Barrow, was interviewed by Jules, and Jews basically, you know how Jews are pressure and say, hold that, you're selling, you get nine, you only get six. And he's like, a win, though, a win. win that will win, basically. How he got his seats, he got more than he had before. He's going to be taking that. He gained the seats as compared to the last municipal, and, you know, he's going to ride on that wave. So he said he was going to get 9 municipalities. He only got 1 municipality, and they went fully at 1 because they still have Walid Dasha Blue, because we have Councillor Aaron Mai that's also on the San Ignacio Santa Elena Council too as well. And he's like, you know what? We are take what we get. We realized we had strategic error. That's that. Strategic error. Funds were pulled into, by the way. Did you hear when he said how that compared to all the other leaders, he pulled in the most funds? And I was just like,
sips water.
Hydrated, I needed to be.
But yeah, that's why you call it a strategic error.
A strategic error.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes.
I think in general with this overall synopsis and his analysis, you know, Jules is really pushing for him to just say that, you know what, we lost this one. We really have to go back to the drawing board. We have to really kind of see exactly where we're going wrong. We put a lot of funds into this. And even he, leader of the opposition, Shine Barra, said that he wished that, you know, he had pushed the funds into the ones that were more promising for him as compared to pushing all across to us all, because there were some certain places that my landslide that was sweep out, north side just gone. And I think Jules even mentioned about Hugo Pat and his area that was like nothing. They didn't get anything really for that. And it just goes to show of like, are the people really for the UDP or not tired of the PUP, that's the case too as well.
What was an interesting comment about that when I interviewed Prime Minister John Bresenio was, the way how people feel about the leadership of the United Democratic Party. So they're saying, if the people came out, at least while I was reporting in Orange Walk, he said, you can see that they support the leaders that for the People's United Party. So people will show up, right? It could be their fanatism or they really connect with the vision of the PUP. He said, people, do you see any United Democratic Party here? There's very few, and that speaks for how they feel about the leader, how they feel about the team. I was like, okay, that's an interesting analysis. However, how Shine Barra mentioned, you know, it's a strategic error. So a loss is a win is a win.
A win
regardless
is a win.
If it was just, you know, one municipality that went red in this year's municipal elections. I'm talking about, you know, funds that got pulled into municipal elections on Wednesday. You know, the word on the street is to call it bacon. So somebody, one of the reporters that was working out in Punta Gorda monitoring the municipal elections, got assaulted by somebody that was participating in this disbursement of bacon. So we have some footage to share with you as this reporter, you know, was doing his duty covering elections watch. And when he found, you know,
the bacon house,
mm-hmm. there was this person that picked up a rock and assaulted him, you know, to push the camera and everything.
Yeah, you could see fierce deep up in the camera. I'm like, sir,
yes.
Brother man, what a thing, eh? And yeah, see right here, pick up a rock in the comata. He just stay up and tracking his own rush. hey, drop camera. You know how you know when a camera drop good? Because you see the flip. Like, you know when it, like, there's a ruffle in that. And you know, he was just trying to capture the moment, because people, we always talk about the bacon house. We know that it's a real thing, but we don't necessarily always get to see the footage of it. And so he was able to capture a small footage of just what he would believe is alleged bacon house, where you see people lined up, going in, coming out like this. And this is right here too as well. people say we'd wait for $50 or whatever it is. And that's if for anybody or any viewer that doesn't understand what a bacon house is, like we said before, it's just that spot where people can go in and get their different funds or stipends for doing the work that they're doing or for just being able to vote too as well. So it ranges from what, but that's where the money to come from. The money to get pumped into that bacon house. The money needs to be provided.
So like what happened, it's unfortunate what happened to this journalist in Punta Gorda. And that leads into the next culture topic, where I share my experience of what happened during heat check in Orange Walk. The big thing is, I have a mad respect for reporters. You know, this opportunity to participate in the monitoring of municipal elections in Orange Walk allowed me to empathize with the work that reporters do. And I have to say, it's nothing easy. When you have to talk about the conditions of being out there, Orange Walk was ridiculously hot. So it was dehydrating. Also, the fact that you have to moving all over the place for you to capture the moment and for you to capture like be like the first one out there to get the fresh news. So I remember Charisse, you know, just being scouting out there and just finding the right source, finding the right news. I had her in mind as I was doing my cover. I also like had Jo Marie when she recently was covering, you know, what happened at the Cane Farmers Association protest, where she was there all night waiting for her to get the final result. And I was like, wow, if Jo Marie could do it, if Charisse can do it, I can also do it. I also want to big up Brian Castillo. You know,
yes.
When we were having the initial conversations talking about how he checked, what are the expectations of our deliverables, I was quite intimidated when I heard about it. And so I was like, who's going to be with me? Because I'm like, am I going to be by myself in Orange Walk Town? But they're like, Brian is coming with you. So I was like, okay, good. I'm in really good hands.
Yeah.
So I just want to big up Brian for the support and for a fantastic job out there in Orange Walk on Wednesday. But the heat was intense.
Yes, yeah. It really seems so. When I went out to go and vote, it felt hot. So I imagine for Uno, we're in all different parts, and you have to really run. And what people don't understand, like, people are tuned in all the time. They were excited, they were tuned in, but they don't understand the groundwork that people have to do. Like, you have to look wrong to see what happened, rush to get that story, make sure you demand the surroundings at all times. Then you also get forced, or you are susceptible to what the PG representative down there got.
Yes.
People want to come and attack you, you know. There's a lot of things that happen. Then, not only when you try to get this story, sometimes people don't want to talk to you, they rush behind if you try to get a lead conversation, whatever it is.
Yeah.
You have to have good eyes. It's a lot. It's a lot.
That's true. I mean, what I have to say, though, is that I got to be thankful for the person that I interviewed, that they were like, yes, Kevin, for sure.
Aww.
I can share some, especially our Prime Minister, John Bersenio. He was like, you again? Come, make me talk, right? So I was like, thank
chest
you.
Chest not sweet, me, but juice.
Yeah, of course.
Like, that juice, senor. Juice, make a follow.
And that was interesting, because we're busy like capturing the scene because we met Commissioner of Police at the polling station where they were counting the votes. And so we missed him, right? And I'm like, man, we missed the opportunity to interview Compo. That's the thing out there. We're just looking at opportunity here, opportunity there. Like, let's get the news.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm like, we missed him. So we asked one of the police officers, like, can you please go ask Compo if he could do an interview for Channel 7? You can tell he loved Channel 7 because he was like, yeah, man, make that come true. And I was like, there you go. And that was like a very candid moment with him, just sharing his perspective about the municipal elections. So I got to thank everybody that was willing to get interviewed. I got to thank Orange Walk for being so receptive out there. They were like, Kevin, you know, like, it's good to have you here. We enjoy the show.
Aww.
We enjoy Sunup on 7, and it's good that you're here, you know, doing the coverage and everything. And then people were giving water here and there. And
That's
it was like,
so sweet.
It was so good. It was so good. So big up Orange Walk.
Big up
thank
today.
You so much for the receptivity. And of course, it was an experience for the books.
Wow, yeah. I really love that, guys. Like, for the extension of not even just compliment, but the giving of water. And
stuff.
Look at you guys. I'm not going to give water beautiful. To the construction officers and all the people out there to where they work hard. But no, thank you so much. Because again, being in media and doing, like, you know, doing that job is not easy.
Yeah.
It's not. It's tedious. It's hard. It's long hours. How early were you out there?
So we left Belize City at 4:30. Just to be there for 6 o'clock, and
so
we left.
I would like you to say 4:30 a.m. baby.
4:30 a.m.
Thank you.
To be there for 6 a.m. and we left Orange Walk until 11:30 p.m. when we got the final countdown report. So imagine, and polls closed at 6, and we had to wait 5.5 hours
just to get some results.
So you
just wait wrong.
We're just waiting around, super tired, dehydrated. So again,
Joe Marie.
Mad respect to reporters. Yes.
Remember what her picture when she made us to wait outside?
Yeah, I totally empathize now. Yep.
Yeah. So big up to you, Kev. Congratulations on having a beautiful experience like that. Just
Thank
to understand
you.
And be able to, you know, really empathize with the hardworking media places across the country that make sure we get the stories that we need for updates.
That's true. And I came back tanned. I came back quite sunburned.
Somebody said, Kev, you only look toast to beans. You look properly sunburned.
The heat was real.
That's how you normally buy me the work. Because if you never look sunburned, you know, get no story. But also, we'll have to big up Rydell too as well, you know, for putting together the stories, making sure that the scoop is given, because the raw materials taken from Kevin and Courtney and everybody, and then Maliba have to make sure everything come together too as well. So there's a lot of hands on deck to make sure Heat Check was a success that it was. Big up to Brent again for making sure the coordination was on point too as well. And of course, with Prem TV, you know, we love that partnership with Plus TV too as well, having all of those different places come together to make sure we have the proper Heat Check. And it was hot! Whew.
It was hot.
Do that again.
Yeah, it hurts. So I refrained from doing that. You can do it again though.
Okay. All right, guys. So with the move on, we have.
So with that, we're come to the end of our, not couch talk today, it's table talk. It's our
table
white table talk conversation on a Friday.
We do want to have an important announcement too as well, the DPP has sent out a directive for a charge for ORJ on the attempts for rape too as well. As you remember, back in January, there were the alleged reports from a resident from Cayo and from Belize City that said that when they were out at Thursday's with OJ, they met him and they had drinks and all these things, and he was supposed to take them home, and then he offered to carry them to his house, and they went, and the whole situation and everything. There was a lot of investigation. There was a lot of people saying X, Y, and Z. We want to let you know that investigations have been taking place, and the DPP has sent out the directive for OJ to be charged. He has not been charged as yet, but the directive has been sent out. So keeping you updated on what is happening with that. You know what I have to say again too, Kev, when I saw this story come out, again, people in their comments with the victim blaming and victim shaming and saying, because they're saying that because the girls went to his house to have drinks, they say, what do you think will happen if you have drinks? I'm like,
really?
Lord, no make I choose violence to death on this blessed Friday morning.
I
really would want us, especially in Women's Month, to change the culture of how we see when women are in vulnerable positions and thinking that they ask for it or they deserve it because of being a situation. Because again, we have the rights over our body. We can choose to not want to engage in sexual activity. We should not be forced to do something just because we are under the influence. That means that we should be swayed to do what the next person wants in any way, shape, or form. So let's have some respect for people, for the traumatic experience that they have to go through, because they now have to be survivors from what they went through too as well, and go through all of that. So again, sending the love to the women out there that have hard stories and are afraid to tell the stories because of how our country is and its culture is, with shaming people for what they're going through and saying, you ask for it, you deserve it, whatever it is. What's your situation? If you never got out, this never happened, you could get a club, whatever it is, just stop it, man. Just stop it.
Yes. So this is a big development, because a lot of folks were questioning, will this attorney be charged for rape? So from January, when a report was made and the investigation started, it's March, a couple months after. Nevertheless, the investigation proves that now attorney OJ Ellington is going to be charged for rape. We're going to stay tuned to the news and see when will this charge happen.
So we're going to keep you informed, guys. We also want to do two quick birthday shout-outs. For Shania, I see you in the comments, baby girl. Happy, blessed birthday, Shania Garnett, baby girl. I know she turns another day sexy, or she says 28, right? So we're happy. We're sending you happy birthday wishes. Wherever you are, I'm praying that it's filled with all the love and joy and happiness that you have a new chapter to fulfill in the best way possible. May you continue to be raised up and molded into a woman of God and a happy person, and give yourself so much grace that you deserve and the love that you deserve, and surround yourself with all that too as well. So sending you all the happy birthday greetings, as well as your birthday twin, my big brother, Kerwick Samuels. I want to send you a happy birthday wish, big bro. Look at you, getting another day older, another year older too as well. Sending you all the love and happiness and everything that you deserve, bro. May this new chapter be filled with a lot more opportunities, prosperity, happiness, and peace. May you continue to grow and make your mistakes and, you know, love them along the way, because they're making you to be the person that God wants you to be. So sending you all that love, and I love you dearly.
I just heard Ren say, yeah, bro, and yeah. Bro, and bro. So yeah, bro,
like,
happy birthday,
G.
Bro.
Yeah,
happy
like, birthday, bro. G. Yeah, that my little sis. Thanks, man.
All right, bro, happy birthday.
But yes, again, thank you so much, Kerr, and sending you all that love. Okay, and we've come to the ending of our couch talk. Mm-hmm. Just like that. Well, our table talk. We have a sunrise for you, I believe. I'm not sure exactly who it is from. But, we do also want to mention that later on today, guys, we're going to be having a really nice giveaway. So if you can stay tuned for that, there's a huge function that's going to be happening at Kisses and Bites that is in honor of three amazing women women-led businesses too as well, and they're doing a Foodie Friday at Kisses at Bites from 3 p.m. to 7 p.m. This is a collaboration with Sangria Mia, and they're having a soft launch with the passion fruit sangria flavor. You can be able, this whole giveaway is going to be like a charcuterie board, sangria, and a dessert from Kisses and Bites. So please stay tuned for that.
I want some of that.
You want that?
I want some of that.
not Kevin, so we want some of that. And it looked really, really nice though as well. I was like, it's a grazing board, Kisses and Bites and Sangria Mia. I'm just like, how can I go wrong with that combination? Yeah. I get every single thing I want.
Sounds like a great way to start the long weekend.
And big up to these ladies who are coming together too as well. Where women are together, action will be happening. Change will be happening. Movements will be happening. So big up these women. And yes, look forward for that giveaway later on today. So now we get the segment. Okay. I don't even know who y'all be from too as well. Like today is just like, what day?
Today.
Oh, this is just from whatever. This is from Belize City. Ooh, look at the sky. What's those clouds again, Kevito?
You don't remember.
No, I don't remember. I have no shame in my game. I don't remember. If I don't write it down, I don't want to let people need to write it down and say it out loud.
Okay. I'll wait for you to remember.
I'm going to need you to teach me Kevito again. So let me write it down. Say it. Say it again.
Zero cumulus clouds.
Okay, I can't spell that. Can you use it in a sentence?
We are showing a photo with cirrus cumulus clouds.
Cirrus.
But we want to thank our viewer for submitting this beautiful sunrise of Belize City. Folks, we have a great Friday prepared for you today on Sunup on 7. We're going to be learning how to crochet today, Ren.
That's I'm gonna super be excited for
I've
that.
Never crocheted. And we're also going to be having dance performance in the studio by Dee's Dance Studio. And of course, talking about International Women's Day with an international expo. Folks, with that, we're going to go on our first commercial break. When we're back, stay tuned because we're going to be doing some crochet here on the set.
Ooh, ooh. Then we get it together. Let's go twist it up.
Wake up to positivity and inspiration. It's a fresh and diverse twist on your mornings. Tune in to Sunup on 7 every weekday morning at 6:30 a.m. right here on your nation station, Channel 7. It's the morning show you don't want to miss.
We have delicious pizzas from 4 to 12 slices. Pepperoni, Hawaiian, meat lovers, Mexican pizza, and full house supreme pizza. Wings from 10 pieces up in regular and spicy barbecue. Honey mustard, chipotle, garlic parmesan, tangy barbecue, spicy buffalo, and lemon pepper. Delivery also available. Call 620-9805 to order.
Tenemos la capacidad técnica, operativa, profesional y la infraestructura de poder establecer una atención neurológica de alta calidad.
Que no se pierda tiempo de forma innecesaria para poder al final del día llegar al mejor de los resultados y la mejor opción para el paciente.
Buy me one caro consomme.
Caro consomme. Caro. Mr. Sam, Mr. Sam, give me a...
You want egg? Oh, you want consomme.
Caro consomme.
Caro consomme. The best taste and the best price. Less fat, more flavor. Caro consomme. Available in packets for only 20 cents and a half pound jar for only $2.75. Less fat, more flavor, more savings.
Give me a
Caro consomme.
Taste the savings, love the flavor.
Wake up to positivity and inspiration. It's a fresh and diverse twist on your mornings. Tune in to Sunup on 7 every weekday morning at 6:30 a.m. right here on your nation station, Channel 7. It's the morning show you don't want to miss.
Two teams fighting for position. mission. Two teams fighting for a city. Only one can prevent.
Defenders don't frighten over nobody.
Police City, your high octane, sharp shooting, high flying. Police City Defenders returns home, boasting a 4-0 record. And are hoping and eager to serve up a loss to their intercity rivals, the Venice Hurricanes. Muy Uno Resort and Old Capital Sports get set to bring the biggest Friday Night Lights episode of this 2024 BEPL season. And it goes down this Friday, March 8th, inside the Police City Civic Center. Fans, look out for major giveaways like resort stays courtesy Muy Uno and our big halftime 1-2-3 cooking oil challenge for not one, not two, not three, but $4,000 in whole hard cash. Don't miss it! Sponsors!
Take a minute. Imagine yourself in that long road trip in that dream vehicle. Right now, that dream may seem a bit far-fetched, but with Real Deal Auto Sales, that dream can be realized. We not only have quality and reliable vehicles, but affordable vehicles. Did someone say layaway? Yes! Call us today at 613-1889. Ask about our layaway plans or visit us at 2736 Hummingbird Highway, Belmopan, right across from the showgrounds. Be a boss with Real Deal Auto Sales.
Nando's Wholesale is the distributor for the full line of Badia spices, including the original Complete Seasoning, the perfect combination of ingredients and spices prepared to enhance the natural flavor of your favorite foods. Also, cinnamon powder for all your desserts, fruits, and beverages, and as special dishes. All these are available in commercial sizes or restaurant packaging. Nando's products are available at your local retailer or contact us at 222-5000. From Corozal to Toledo, Nando's is proud to be serving Belize as its number one wholesale distributor for over 35 years.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
Can you produce your driver's license, please?
Sure, no problem.
Okay, Mr. Vernon, it's valid.
Yep.
Mr. Vernon, did you know your insurance will be up tomorrow?
Oh, really?
Make sure you try to update your policy, please.
Thanks so much for the heads up.
Babe, can you please renew my policy?
We know that you get caught up in life sometimes, which is why RF&G Insurance makes renewing your insurance policy easy with WhatsApp. Just WhatsApp the words GET STARTED to 670-8700. We will prompt you to select the service you are interested in. Select the service and answer a few simple questions. An RF&G representative will process your request and follow up with you when your transaction is completed. It's that easy. Use WhatsApp and skip the lines. Remember, it pays to get it right with RF&G Insurance, a Roe Group company.
Wake up to positivity and inspiration. It's a fresh and diverse twist on your mornings. Tune in to Sunup on 7 every weekday morning at 6:30 a.m. right here on your Nation station, Channel 7. It's the morning show you don't want to miss.
We have delicious pizzas from 4 to 12 slices. Pepperoni, Hawaiian, meat lovers, Mexican pizza, and full house supreme pizza. Wings from 10 pieces up in regular and spicy barbecue. Honey mustard, chipotle, garlic parmesan, tangy barbecue, spicy buffalo, and lemon pepper. Delivery also available. Call 620-9805 to order.
Buy me one Carol Consomme.
Carol, 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 Carol. Mr. Sam, give me a...
You want egg? Oh, you want consomme?
Coral consomme.
Coral consomme. The best taste and the best price. Less fat, more flavor. Coral consomme. Available in packets for only 20 cents and a half pound jar for only $2.75. Less fat, more flavor, more savings.
Give me a
Coral consomme.
Taste the savings. Love the flavor.
Two teams fighting for position. Two teams fighting for a city. Only one can prevent.
Defenders don't frighten of nobody.
Belize City, your high octane, sharp shooting, high flying. Belize City Defenders returns home, boasting a 4-0 record. And are bold and eager to serve up a loss to their intercity rivals, the Venice Hurricanes. Muy Uno Resort and Old Capital Sports get set to bring the biggest Friday Night Lights episode of this 2024 BEPL season. And it goes down this Friday, March 8th, inside the Belize City Civic Center. Fans, look out for major giveaways like resort stays courtesy Muy Uno and our big halftime 1-2-3 cooking oil challenge. For not one, not two, not three, but $4,000 in whole hard cash. Don't miss it! Sponsors!
Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
Can you produce your driver's license, please?
Sure, no problem.
Okay, Mr. Vernon, it's valid.
Yep.
Mr. Vernon, did you know your insurance will be up tomorrow?
Oh, really?
Make sure you try to update your policy, please.
Thanks so much for the heads up. Babe, can you please renew my policy?
We know that you get caught up in life sometimes, which is why RFNG Insurance makes renewing your insurance policy easy with WhatsApp. Just WhatsApp the words "get started" to 670-8700. We will prompt you to select the service you are interested in. Select the service and answer a few simple questions. An RFNG representative will process your request and follow up with you when your transaction is completed. It's that easy. Use WhatsApp and skip the lines. Remember, it pays to get it right with RFNG Insurance, a Roe Group company.
My beautiful people, welcome back to Sunup on 7. Thank you so much for engaging with Renata and I on this Friday. It's time for us to welcome our first guest on this white table. And we have Miss Adelina Chan. She's the creator of Adeli's Collection. Today we're going to be learning how to crochet a coaster. If it is the first time that you're crocheting, or if this is a practice, we hope that you engage with us. For me, it's a very interesting conversation to engage into, because it reminds me of my grandmother, you know, during summers when we used to go to her house, and we'd be like, you know, we want to do something creative, and she'd be like, okay, well, let's learn something. So crocheting was it at some point during childhood. So Adelina, thank you so much for bringing this nostalgic feel, and of course for joining us today on Sunup on 7. How are you feeling today?
Hey, hello. Good morning. I'm feeling good.
Yeah, how is your Friday energy?
Energized. Rested.
Very good.
Yes. Those are all the great feelings.
Those are all the great feelings for start the day.
For Friday,
sure,
especially on a long
happy,
weekend.
Happy, right?
Well. Yes, man. I hope you don't feel frustrated after this segment with us.
No,
I'm learning.
Sure.
I've been through the process, so I understand.
Okay, perfect.
More or less.
So talking about going through the process, Adelina, what got you into doing crochet?
Okay, well, basically, I work at a circulation therapy clinic, namely Anodyne Therapy Center, and I deal with a lot of elderly people. Mm. And one day I went to a client's house and she was crocheting, but it was so interesting because she had rheumatoid arthritis. Basically all her bones and joints in her fingers, they were bent. Mm-hmm. And she found a very unique way of taking the yarn in all her fingers and everything and crocheting, and she was making a blanket, and really got me interested. I'm like, well, if she can do it, I could do it too. Like, Miss Jules, can you like show me how you do that, you know? And so she explained everything, and then I went home and I began researching, and I basically learned on the internet.
Wow.
Everything. Yeah.
Internet taught me how to do my small business.
Basically.
I love it. So we're here today, and I know when you came with Nime, it was like a big group of you. So we have you now here a little bit on a smaller scale, so I'm going to ask you more questions. But what all things do you knit to as well?
Okay, so
crochet, sorry.
Yeah, crochet. Basically what I started off with was pet accessories. So I did like hats, fashion collars, dresses, you know, different little things like that. Mm. Then I ventured on into women fashion. So I started off with like blouse and swimsuits and then earrings, and now I do flower bouquets and so more and more I'll start to do bags very soon. Girl, and everything. So
watch me to flick my crochet. Gotcha.
Yes.
So we're here now and we have
our equipment.
Equipment.
Because you know that's the beauty about crocheting. You don't need a lot. Just need your needle and you need your yarn and your
good to go.
And your creativity.
Yes.
Yeah. Or just some really good music. Right.
And just get a nice going. Podcast.
Yes.
I love it. So talk about how it's big for your mental health also, right?
Oh yes, it has helped me so much, you know, especially working with a lot of sick people. You know, sometimes I go home and I'm very stressed out, and my family sometimes see me frustrated, and I just go into my projects and I just disappear in that. Oh. And it's better to not take out my anger with them than in my project. So
of course. So Adeli, I'm sure Renata is excited about this.
I'm here.
So we're gonna be doing a crochet 101 here with Adelina.
Yes.
We're excited to get started here.
Yeah. So basically what we need with crochet is a crochet hook. Which we have, and you guys have the bigger size because you're just starting off, mm-hmm. and it's easier to control with that. We need scissors and a weaving needle.
Okay.
This is specially made for especially knitting and crochet projects because it doesn't have a pointed end. Mm. So when we're finished, we're going to weave in the ends and everything.
Okay.
So to basically start off, right, we're going to, I already showed you guys a little how to control your tension of the yarn between your fingers. Kevin has it. Yes, Renata has it. And then what I like to do, I like to leave in a long end so that you have enough to weave in or make up for any mistakes. Yes.
Oh, yeah, I'm going to need to sort for mistakes.
I'm going to make it longer.
I'm going to make it a little longer because I'm like, this is for the
12 inches.
Girl, yeah. Here it is. I can flip it and everything.
Yeah. Okay, so with coasters, it's very easy. It's basically a box. Mm-hmm. So, and for starters, it's very good. So we're going to do a slip knot.
Slip knot.
So we're going to twist the yarn.
Like that.
Yeah, uh-huh. And then either you can do it with your fingers or with the hook. So you can weave in your hook.
Mm-hmm.
Hook. You can go either over or under, whichever one you're comfortable with, and pass it through. And then this end here, the end that is out.
Mm-hmm. My long.
Yeah, you just pull it. So you create a nice little knot there.
It's supposed to knot there.
Not happen.
Okay. So yeah, you're
there
gonna
it
twist,
is.
Push the right through, hook it. And okay, so I see what you're doing.
Uh-huh.
So basically you're going to twist. You're gonna hold here. Yeah. Push through, hook it, and pull. You're going to have to give it here a little slack. Right here, a little slack. Pull it through. All right. And then this end here, yeah, you're going to pull that.
Okay.
So, all right.
Look
this.
At you.
We
you got it. I'm here. I'm
good student.
Look at you. All right.
All right.
First big step.
All right.
And then after.
Wipe sweat.
Okay. I know, right? Like, okay, we got through like the hardest obstacle that this person put. All led me up to this.
All right. So we're going to do, all right. So basically, this is what we call a chain. You're going to hook it around the hook like that. Mm-hmm. Pull through, and that's basically it. And that's what we call a chain.
I'm actually in Milan.
So one hook.
One hook.
Yeah.
My gosh. This is making me sweat.
You're going to have to hold it here at the knot so you can have good control. Exactly. See?
And pull through.
Yeah.
And pull the knot. Pull in the knot.
Yeah. Pull it right through the hole. Perfect. Oh! Perfect.
Okay.
Yeah. So you're going to have to hold right here.
Hold there. Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Hold it.
Yeah. So you can have good control. And then with your fingers. Exactly. And then you're going to... Okay.
Like that?
Yeah. And then pull right through.
Wait, I'm going to need you to let me pull. Hold on.
We need four hands.
The girl, it's giving I need the octopus level here.
Yeah.
Okay. Miley hole.
Yeah.
Okay, there it is.
Yeah, yeah.
Because I'm going to think we did hook this.
Yes. Okay. Basically. You can go over, you could go under, whichever one.
Girl, I'm going whatever way my hand just decided to go.
And then you pull here, you hold right here with your two fingers, uh-huh. And then that's basically a chain right there.
Ooh, okay. Uh-huh. I've got my chain.
Yeah.
Let's do
it. And so we're going to do 10 of that.
So,
wait, 10 of that?
Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
Is it supposed to be tight?
For now, no. Because you're going to, if you do practice more and more, then yes, you're going to learn.
And then I will just
to make it more tight. But for now, you're not going to. Exactly.
Okay.
Exactly.
So 10 of those.
Yeah, 10 of those. You're gonna have to.
I'm gonna need
keep
you
it to tight, right?
Hold right here,
that
and then
be great.
Weave it. Right round, and then you hold with these fingers, exactly.
Oh. Okay.
Come back now!
I'm sorry if your hands cramp you later on.
It's okay, baby girl. At this present moment, I'm just trying to make my hands do what they're supposed to do in the first place right now. There we go.
Renata is getting it!
Baby girl!
You too, you're getting there. It's like a
race. This is a muscle memory for Kev, right? Listen to me.
Yeah, thank you, Gran, for teaching me this.
So that's basically it.
Okay.
So let me show you how you count your chains now.
Look at this. I'm going there.
I think I'm at
2, 3, 4.
Yeah, every V is a chain.
Okay.
So right here.
How tight is it supposed to be?
Okay, let me show you mine.
I bet you should both do this in like 5 seconds, right? Yeah. And then I'm going to be here like,
I am making
so
something.
So every V here, this is the front side of the chains. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Okay.
So you have 4 more to go.
To me?
And you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. You have 3 more.
Okay. That's 1. That's 2. I'm gonna need the last one to be. Stop being disrespectful. Your needle ever disrespect you? Because it feels like it's doing that. Okay, there we go.
Yeah. Let me see.
Okay. I am like, how much have I done? But it's okay.
She counted like nothing, and I'm just here like.
Yeah,
like,
every V you see here. Is a chain, so it's going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Okay,
6, see,
7, I've done 8, something, 9, it's not 10. As
see, your tension is getting better right here.
Yay, awesome!
Yeah,
okay, Adelina, great. I've done how tight is it supposed to be? Tighter?
Well, this is mine here.
I'm not doing better because Kev said how it don't need to be tight.
Well, okay. For in the beginning, no.
Okay, all right.
Yeah.
Okay, so we're just doing the basics of getting how to hook.
So basically how I do it, so your coffee cups are there. You're going to measure if it fits underneath it well. 10 stitches is supposed to fit.
It does fit,
yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, it does fit.
All right.
Okay. I can see. This is a lot of multitasking because I have to count also. Count.
Bruh.
All
right.
Okay.
Bruh. Okay.
All right. So you need a break? Or?
No, let's continue.
I'm just like, wow. All
right. So in crochet, you have many different stitches now. These are what you call chains.
Chains.
Okay. These are what every project starts off with.
Okay.
And for you, it's going to be 10 chains. Okay, so what we're going to do today is a very simple, it's what we call single crochet.
Okay. Uh-huh.
Yeah. We have single, we have half double, we have double and triple and different stitches.
I'm gonna use single.
Single. Let's stay single. Okay.
I'm gonna go easy on me, girl. Cause she's like, we have single, we have double, we have triple double. I'm like, big girl.
Wanted to make earrings?
Yeah. I wanted originally, but I'm taking it back now.
Okay. Okay. So what we're gonna do with the single, we're going to go up that way. So we're going to go, we're going to stitch that way. We're going to literally form.
So this is the base, basically what you're saying.
Yeah, we're gonna go up. All right, so the loops that are up here are what we're going to work in. So all the ones that are on this side here, it's better to let me show you.
I'm going to show you. Yeah. I'm going to need you to show
so
me.
So basically, with single, you're going to do one chain.
Uh-huh.
And then, not this one that you made just now, the one after that. Uh-huh. We like to call it the second chain.
Uh-huh. Second chain.
Yeah, you basically loop through the upper loop like that.
Okay.
Grab the yarn that is on this hand, pull it through,
mm-hmm.
and you're gonna have two.
So, you sure this is the easiest one we could do?
Yeah.
I'm just checking for a friend.
Yeah. Your friend it's the easiest one.
Because you're going to loop the loop.
And basically, then you're going to loop again.
Oh my gosh.
loop again.
You loop. Okay.
And then pull through the two.
Okay.
And that's your single crochet. I can show again.
So I'm going to need you to show it again, girl. I'm going to need you
The next one from here, we're going to go right here.
Okay.
So again, push through the top loop.
The top loop. Top loop. Push.
Yarn over. Pull through.
I have two.
Pull through again on the two, and that's basically it.
Okay. We're going to do it step by step. Okay. So I'm going to do the top part.
Right. So you do one chain.
One chain. Yeah. I have to do an next chain, right? All right. So...
Okay,
come
this
on,
does
chain.
Not look like. This is not how it's supposed to look. Joe.
This is not, baby boo. Okay, I ain't even started yet. Hold on, my one chain has been made. Mm-hmm. Okay, and then I go into
not that one, the second one after that. You're gonna go on the top loop. You're
this
gonna
one.
Push through
this loop, right? This loop.
Right. But you're gonna go from the front, into the right here.
This one, yeah.
Yeah.
Here, okay. I'm gonna need my needle.
Right, okay, there we go. Yarn over.
Wait, what? Yarn over?
Hook it.
Okay, I'm gonna need you to say, not say yarn over. Just say hook the thing right. Okay, pull through?
Yeah, pull through.
Hold on.
We'll be with you, Kevin, don't worry.
Yeah, I feel like I catch back pain again. That's right to do.
Hold on, Kev. Baby boo, I'm gonna need you note to me. Why this?
Right, exactly, and pull.
Hold on, baby girl. And I get through the next one.
Yeah, no. It's that one.
Okay, it's that one.
Exactly two. And then...
You know, while we get going with this, I just want to invite our viewers that are watching us through Facebook to let us know if you do crochet.
You're gonna yarn
what has your experience been like? You know, put a heart out there if you are doing crochet.
Pull it through the two.
I
two of them.
Yeah, two of them.
All right, okay. Woo! All right, it pulled.
So there you have it. All right, Kevin,
so
now.
I feel the determining factor in why my crochet is not working out is because my stitches are loose.
Yeah.
Right?
So I'm trying to figure out where's the top and the bottom.
failed.
Tell me you're failing without telling me you're failing.
Okay.
Figure
I understand
out where
you
your
now.
One ends and begins.
So you already did your chain one.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah. So I go here.
The second, you're going to go through the front. Yeah.
I get through the front.
You get there, baby boo. You get through
the front
though.
And then hook more.
Yeah.
This.
For anybody that knows crocheting
cross it
out there,
both
I want to
know
how much respect
on one.
I have
one
for
now.
You. I want you to know you're an amazing person. God loves you.
Exactly.
I just want you to know all of that.
Uh-huh.
Okay?
Yeah, you're just going to have to pull it a little bit more. Yeah. Just like that. Okay, now you're going to hook it again and pull it through these two loops.
Here.
Yeah.
Okay.
So you want to give it a little distance so that you have enough space to work.
Oh,
yeah.
Okay. And then
pull
here again.
Yeah.
And hook.
Mm-hmm. You're going to...
And then pull it through
hold
both.
Hold it here.
Pull it here.
So you can have good, yeah.
My gosh. You know, I am not good at multitasking. Okay. And then I pull it through both.
Yeah.
Pull it through
the both. Okay. Is this the second or the third?
I'm short. Okay.
All right.
All right.
Am I supposed to put it through this one or this one?
No, you're going to do it with
this one.
Okay,
I had to correct that. Perfect.
And you do that over and over until you reach the end of the,
okay.
the row.
All right. So it's always supposed to be passing through two loops?
Or? You're going to pass through the first top one.
Okay. Pass through.
The first top one.
And then you loop and then you pass through there. Okay. Leave it enough space. And then I loop again.
Loop again and then through the two loops.
Oh. Okay. Huh. This does
That's
not look.
Basically it.
This does not look like it's gonna make a coaster. But
this is what I wanted
Are
to
you?
Make earrings because they were smaller.
The earrings is a different method. You have to make a circle and.
Oh my god!
This is basically a straight line.
I want you to know it's not therapy until you learn how to do it correctly. It's not therapy until you learn how to do it correctly.
Yes.
Because I'm just like, all right, boo, boo, boo.
Wait. I think you already did your second.
Yeah, I did the second one.
Yeah, okay.
You
so
already did that, Ren.
I did that, and yeah. Okay, what do I do now?
The next one.
Oh, this is a mini coaster. I've done a mini coaster.
What can I say? That is sweet, sweet. Hold on. Okay. All right, we're here.
This is a jumble.
It just looks like a ball of yarn that
okay.
I've knitted.
I mean, I think all beginnings can look messy,
yes,
but
yes.
It's at the bigger
it's
picture. Yeah, thank you for that.
Well, that's why I decided
words.
On the poster because even though if it does look messy, it looks like a little design. So
there you go.
My one even looked like a ball. It looked like a peanut. So wait, is that correct?
Oh,
you know what? Wait, did I do that correct?
Yeah, yeah, you actually did. Yeah.
And that's how you look when I do it correct. Okay, after that, then
yeah.
I loop again.
Yeah, you loop again. You do the same thing over and over until you
reach
it.
But only the first one, right? Only the first one you loop.
Yeah. First, or exactly two, and then you loop again,
and
then
this. Okay.
Pass through the two loops.
Adelina, I have to say, you know, like, this is it's a challenge. And you're motivating me to, like, go and get a needle and a bag of yarn because I need to get... This is just Kevin. I need to learn how to do this.
Okay. So we're gonna take a break.
Yeah.
We're gonna get back to this, definitely. We're gonna take a break at this time. You know what? I love how I did something.
Yeah, actually yours is having good progress. You see, this is right here.
Ooh.
The more we do, the more it gets wider.
All right, folks.
Okay.
All right. Adelina, so for folks that were interested in getting your products, where can they find you, your catalog, what's your contact number?
Yeah, I have both Facebook and Instagram.
Uh-huh.
Adele Collection.
Uh-huh.
I also have my WhatsApp number available for anybody who's interested. I post most of my products on my WhatsApp as well at 628-6685. So that's basically
very good.
Where anybody can contact me.
Mm-hmm.
And then also... Where are you getting your yarn from? Because
no, that's a very tricky question.
Oh, they have different places, yeah. Okay.
Because every yarn has a different size and texture, and it depends on the design of the project.
Okay.
So sometimes I have to import my yarn. Sometimes if I take trips to abroad, then I would buy it there. Sometimes if some of the stores here in Belize have it, I would stock up. So it all depends on the availability of the yarn. So
very good.
But I normally take pictures of what they have in stock. So if anybody wants to personalize and customize their projects or pieces, I always make sure, you know, tell them what's available. And
so they could know what they could choose from. Yeah.
Yeah. So
Okay.
Okay, look at us. Okay, Now it's getting therapeutic.
Yeah.
Now it's getting therapeutic.
Oh, wow, Renata.
Now it's getting therapeutic.
Oh, look at you.
Yeah. Now I have officially gotten to the therapeutic part because I actually know what I'm doing. Who would have thought? You are a very good teacher. Oh, my goodness. Do you good do job, classes Anita. On Thank this? Because you should do classes on this.
Yes, you should do classes.
I think so. Yeah. I would go to your classes, baby girl.
Thank you so much for bringing...
Because I still know about the double.
Crochet 101 to Sunup on 7 today on this Friday. Thank you. Thank you so much for
your
time.
Thank you for having me.
Wish you all the best in your business. Please contact Adelina or Adelie's collection on her social media pages for you to be able to access one of her products. Mm-hmm. With that, we're going to go on a next commercial break. When we're back, we're going to have D's Dance Studio in the house. And we're going to be dancing some song and getting the vibe on this Friday. Commercial break, we're back here on Sunup on 7.
I think I'm ready for this.
Tenemos la capacidad técnica, operativa, profesional y la infraestructura de poder establecer una atención neurológica de alta calidad.
Que no se pierda tiempo de forma innecesaria para poder al final del día llegar al mejor de los resultados y la mejor opción para el paciente.
We have delicious pizzas from 4 to 12 slices. Pepperoni, Hawaiian, meat lovers, Mexican pizza and Full House Supreme pizza. Wings from 10 pieces. Barbecue, honey mustard, chipotle, garlic parmesan, tangy barbecue, spicy buffalo, and lemon pepper. Delivery also available. Call 620-9805 to order.
Wake up to positivity and inspiration. It's a fresh and diverse twist on your mornings. Tune in to Sunup on 7 every weekday morning at 6:30 a.m. right here on your nation station, Channel 7. It's the morning show you don't want to miss.
Take a minute. Imagine yourself in that long road trip in that dream vehicle. Right now, that dream may seem a bit far-fetched, but with Real Deal Auto Sales, that dream can be realized. We not only have quality and reliable vehicles, but affordable vehicles. Did someone say layaway? Yes! Call us today at 613-1889 to ask about our layaway plans or visit us at 2736 Hummingbird Highway, Belmopan, right across from the showgrounds. Be a boss with Real Deal Auto Sales.
Two teams fighting for position. Two teams fighting for a city. Only one can prevent.
Defenders don't frighten of nobody.
Belize City, your high-octane, sharp-shooting, high-flying Belize City Defenders returns home, boasting a 4-0 record. And are hoping and eager to serve up a loss to their intercity rivals, the Venice Hurricanes. Muy Uno Resort and Old Capital Sports get set to bring the biggest Friday Night Lights episode of this 2024 BEPL season. And it goes down this Friday, March 8th, inside the Belize City Civic Center. Fans, look out for major giveaways like resort stays courtesy Muy Uno and our big halftime 1-2-3 Cooking Oil Challenge for not one, not two, not three, but $4,000 in cold hard cash. Don't miss it, sponsors.
Wake up to positivity and inspiration. It's a fresh and diverse twist on your mornings. Tune in to Sunup on 7 every weekday morning at 6:30 a.m. right here on your nation station, Channel 7. It's the morning show you don't want to miss.
We have delicious pizzas from 4 to 12 slices. Pepperoni, Hawaiian, meat lovers, Mexican pizza, and full house supreme pizza. Wings from 10 pieces up in regular and spicy barbecue. Honey mustard, chipotle, garlic parmesan, tangy barbecue, spicy buffalo, and lemon pepper. 620-9805
Tenemos la capacidad técnica, operativa, profesional y la infraestructura de poder establecer una atención neurológica de alta calidad.
Que no se pierda tiempo de forma innecesaria para poder al final del día llegar al mejor de los resultados y la mejor opción para el paciente.
Buy me one caro consomme.
Caro consomme. Carol. Mr. Sean, give me a...
You want egg? Oh, you want consomme.
Carol consomme. Carol consomme. The best taste and the best price. Less fat, more flavor. Carol consomme. Available in packets for only 20 cents and a half pound jar for only $2.75. Less fat, more flavor, more savings.
Give me a
Carol consomme.
Taste the savings. Love the flavor.
Muy buenos días, my beautiful people. Es viernes, el cuerpo lo sabe, here on Sunup on 7. There's many things to celebrate in March. One of them today is International Women's Day. It's also Child Stimulation Month. It's also a long weekend awaiting. And of course, we got to bring you the excitement here in Sunup on 7. So we have some children that are going to be performing Respect by a song, Respect. And this is D's Dance Studio here on Sunup on 7. So we leave you with this amazing young talent and enjoy the performance.
Thank you.
And we're back on Sunup on 7. If you're watching via Facebook Live, please give some hearts for these amazing artists from D's Dance Studio. Let me introduce who we have here on set. We have Ellie Chang. Ellie, good morning. How are you doing today?
Good.
You're good. Awesome. We also have Sidat Bajia. How are you doing? Sidat, here you are.
I'm good.
You're good. And we also have Ruhani. How are you doing, Ruhani?
Good.
Awesome. So I want to say thank you for dancing this classic, Respect. It's Child Stimulation Month. How have you all been enjoying this month in March?
Good.
Did you do anything at your school?
Yes.
Yes. What did you do? Tell me.
We bought some robotic, like our teacher bought some robotics kit so we could build a robot.
Oh my gosh. Tell me more about your robot.
We are trying to make an amusement park, so a robot controls every single one of the amusement park.
Oh my gosh, that sounds exciting. Yeah, so, all right. Tell me, how about you, Ellie? What did you do this month?
We went to Girls for Tech so we can learn about a lot, like technology and cryptology and like the computer technologies and all.
Oh my gosh, that's the very first time I'm hearing the word cryptology. Did I say it right? Okay, so what robot did you build? Did you build a robot?
No. But we found out what my computer name with numbers.
Yeah, so you learned your binary code.
Yes.
I love it. How about you?
This month we are learning about some music, so we can I don't know what to say.
Okay, take your time.
We will performance.
Okay.
For infant one and infant two.
Oh.
Maybe kindergarten.
Okay.
And we are going to go some more about music.
Okay.
And.
What did you like the most about it?
The beat. The instruments that we're using, bass and all stuff.
Oh, wow. It sounds very exciting, you know? So I want to invite you to give a big shout out to all the kids that are tuned in today to Sunup on 7 and tell them Happy Child Stimulation Month. Can you do that? All right, so come together. 1, 2, 3.
Happy Child Stimulation Month.
Awesome. Thank you. So folks, those are the amazing talent of these dance studios. So we're going to go on a commercial break and we're back here on Sunup on 7.
Capacidad técnica, operativa, profesional y la infraestructura de poder establecer una atención neurológica de alta calidad.
Que no se pierda tiempo de forma innecesaria para poder al final del día llegar al mejor de los resultados y la mejor opción para el paciente.
We have delicious pizzas from 4 to 12 slices. Pepperoni, Hawaiian, meat lovers, Mexican pizza and Full House Supreme pizza. Wings from 10 pieces up in regular and spicy barbecue. Honey mustard, chipotle, garlic parmesan, tangy barbecue, spicy buffalo and lemon pepper. Delivery also available. Call 620-9805 to order.
Wake up to positivity and inspiration. It's a fresh and diverse twist on your mornings. Tune in to Sunup on 7 every weekday morning at 6:30 a.m. right here on your nation station, Channel 7. It's the morning show you don't want to miss.
Take a minute. Imagine yourself in that long road trip in that dream vehicle. Right now, that dream may seem a bit far-fetched, but with Real Deal Auto Sales, that dream can be realized. We not only have quality and reliable vehicles, but affordable vehicles. Did someone say layaway? Yes! Call us today at 613-1889 to ask about our layaway plans or visit us at 2736 Hummingbird Highway, Belmopan, right across from the showgrounds. Be a boss with Real Deal Auto Sales.
Two teams fighting for position. Two teams fighting for a city. Only one can prevent.
Defenders don't frighten nobody.
Police City. Your high octane, sharp shooting, high flying Belize City Defenders returns home boasting a 4-0 record. And are hungry and eager to serve up a loss to their intercity rivals, the Venice Hurricanes. Muy Uno Resort and Old Capital Sports get set to bring the biggest Friday Night Lights episode of this 2024 BEPL season. And it goes down this Friday, March 8th, inside the Belize City Civic Center. Fans, look out for major giveaways like resort stays courtesy Muy Uno and our big halftime 1-2-3 Cooking Oil Challenge. Four, not one, not two, not three, but $4,000 in cold hard cash. Don't miss it. Sponsors.
Wake up to positivity and inspiration. It's a fresh and diverse twist on your mornings. Tune in to Sunup on 7 every weekday morning at 6:30 a.m. right here on your Nation station, Channel 7. It's the morning show you don't want to miss.
We have delicious pizzas from 4 to 12 slices. Pepperoni, Hawaiian, meat lovers, Mexican pizza, and full house supreme pizza. Wings from 10 pieces up in regular and spicy barbecue. Honey mustard, chipotle, garlic parmesan, tangy barbecue, spicy buffalo, and lemon pepper. Delivery also available. Call 620-9805 to order.
Tenemos la capacidad técnica, operativa, profesional y la infraestructura de poder establecer una atención neurológica de alta calidad.
Que no se pierda tiempo de forma innecesaria para poder al final del día llegar al mejor de los resultados y la mejor opción para el paciente.
Buy me one Carl Consume.
Carol. Mr. Sam, give me a...
You want egg?
Uh-uh.
Oh, you want consomme?
Uh-huh.
Carol consomme. The best taste and the best price. Less fat, more flavor. Carol consomme. Available in packets for only 20 cents and a half pound jar for only $2.75. Less fat, more flavor, more savings.
Give me a
Carol Consomme.
Taste the savings. Love the flavor.
Wake up to positivity and inspiration. It's a fresh and diverse twist on your mornings. Tune in to Sunup on 7 every weekday morning at 6:30 a.m. right here on your Nation station, Channel 7. It's the morning show you don't want to miss.
For position, two teams fighting for a city. Only one get prepared.
Defenders don't frighten over nobody.
Belize City, your high octane, sharp shooting, high flying Belize City Defenders returns home boasting a 4-0 record. And are hungry and eager to serve up a loss to their intercity rivals, the Venice Hurricanes. Muy Uno Resort and Old Capital Sports get set to bring the biggest Friday Night Lights episode of this 2024 BEPL season. And it goes down this Friday, March 8th, inside the Belize City Civic Center. Fans, look out for major giveaways like resort stays courtesy Muy Uno and our big halftime 1-2-3 Cooking Oil Challenge. Four, not one, not two, not three, but $4,000 in cold hard cash. Don't miss it. Sponsors.
Take a minute. Imagine yourself in that long road trip in that dream vehicle. Right now,
that dream may seem a bit far-fetched, but with real deal auto sales, that dream can be realized. We not only have quality and reliable vehicles, but affordable vehicles. Did someone say layaway? Yes! Call us today at 613-1889 to ask about our layaway plans or visit us at 2736 Hummingbird Highway, Belmopan, right across from the showgrounds. Be a boss with Real Deal Auto Sales.
Nando's Wholesale is the distributor for the full line of Badia spices, including the original complete seasoning, the perfect combination of ingredients and spices prepared to enhance the natural flavor of your favorite foods. Also, cinnamon powder for all your desserts, fruits, and beverages, and as special dishes. All these are available in commercial sizes or restaurant packaging. Nando's products are available at your local retailer or contact us at 222-5000. From Corozal to Toledo, Nando's is proud to be serving Belize as its number one wholesale distributor for over 35 years.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
Can you produce your driver's license, please?
Sure, no problem.
Okay, Mr. Vernon, it's valid.
Yep.
Mr. Vernon, did you know your insurance will be up tomorrow?
Oh, really?
Make sure you try to update your policy, please.
Thanks so much for the heads up.
Babe, can you please renew my policy?
We know that you get caught up in life sometimes, which is why RFNG Insurance makes renewing your insurance policy easy with WhatsApp. Just WhatsApp the words "get started" to 670-8700. We will prompt you to select the service you are interested in. Select the service and answer a few simple questions. An RFNG representative will process your request and follow up with you when your transaction is completed. It's that easy. Use WhatsApp and skip the lines. Remember, it pays to get it right with RFNG Insurance, a Roe Group company.
Beautiful people, welcome back to Sunup on 7. It's Friday and the vibe is right here on the show. We have, let me just remind you that we have an exciting giveaway after this conversation that we're going to have. And the giveaway is courtesy of women that have been participating in this amazing expo, Women Entrepreneurs. And the giveaway is one small bottle of Sangria by Sangria Mia, one small grazing board by I Love Grazing Boards, and one dessert by Kisses and Bites. So we have an amazing video to show you of these amazing women that are trailblazers, that are putting their name out there, putting their effort, their energy, and I want to congratulate them as today we celebrate International Women's Day. Let's move on into our next conversation. And joining us on our couch, we have representatives of the Ahmadiyya Women's Chapter. Particularly, we have Ms. Deshaun Ellis. Ms. Deshaun, you're the Public Relations Officer of the association. How are you doing today?
I am doing so good. Thank you so much for having us
back
again.
Thank you so much for
joining us this Friday. I know. It's been a hot minute. You guys were hiding, doing great stuff, and then it came back.
Girl, always available, ready.
And we also have Ms. Khadija Hassan. You're the Moral Training Officer of the association. How are you doing today?
I'm doing great. Thank you for having us, and happy Women's Month. Happy Women's
Day.
No, we need
month and day.
We need
the
month.
We need all that.
To everyone that's listening, glad to be here.
Yes. Yeah. So you're representing Ahmadiyya's Women's Chapter, and one particularly you're doing is your third annual International Women's Day Expo. Congratulations for making it to your third one.
Thank you so much.
That's awesome. Right. Yeah, so two things. Can you tell us what is the role of the Ahmadiyya's Women's Chapter and the inspiration behind the expo?
Okay. Now, Ahmadiyya is a sect of Islam that started in 1889. And the reason for the sect was to reinvigorate Islam. Okay.
All right.
So the founder, Hazrat Mirza Ghulam Ahmad, peace be upon him, due to the prophecy of Prophet Muhammad, who started Islam 1400 years ago, uh-huh. he said he came to turn people's heart back to the Creator.
Okay.
People's heart back to God, you know, because they had forgotten that God exists, and that to get the humanity to have better relations among each other.
Very well.
So we are not separatists, we are not isolationists, we integrate into every community that we are a part of.
Certainly.
And Belize is only the 206 community that we are in.
Wow.
Okay, big up.
Big up, for sure, for sure. Thank you for putting that plug in. Yep.
Right, okay.
Yes.
Ms. Khadija with the facts.
That's right. All right.
Yeah. So and then, go ahead, Deshaun. So tell us, how has the annual International Women's Expo been over the years?
Okay, so yes, as you rightly said, it's our third year. Uh-huh. Big up.
Big up. Yes,
we're making it a three.
So yeah, of course we want to be a part of the Women's Month celebrations. Mm-hmm. You know, Women's Day is really a time to remember the unity, the solidarity among women, you know, and sisterhood is also very important in our community as well. You know, we're there through each other's challenges or triumphs through the hardest times, you know, and so this day really prompts us to reach out across any of the barriers that separates us. And really embody what Women's Day is about, that unity, you know. So we, through this expo, we hope to foster those personal connections. We hope to fill some people's bellies.
Girl, you better try to mention that food.
What's funny is that she looked at you directly.
She knows.
Yes, and so while we're, you know, we have the pampering, we also want to try to dispel any of the misconceptions that people may have about women in Islam, you know. So it's really a twofold mm-hmm. event. And let me get into what we're going to be offering.
Very well.
That's what I'm excited about.
Yes. We have some free services, and uh-huh. we did the previous years too. We had free hair braiding, free henna, free nail painting.
Ooh.
Yes, free, you know. So we're pampering, you know, giving back to the women in our community, right? Mm.
I
so
love that.
That's also free eyebrow threading.
Yes.
Girl, stop playing that.
Yes.
Guys.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Oh, girl. I'm going to come true.
And this year, also offering free vital screening. So come Ooh. Check your vitals. We're going to tell
that's
you.
Yeah. I love that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So
it's
every year.
Your yeah. health is important.
And that's a part of self-care.
Yes.
Right? Take care of yourself.
Absolutely.
So, yeah, we're going to have those, and we're also going to have, we're going to be showcasing women talent.
There's some women's business that we'll
yes.
be having.
Yes, so women,
I think
they're
going to do bracelet,
yeah,
there's a bracelet one.
Accessories, skincare. We have the food.
And
we have the desserts.
And dessert.
And dessert.
Yes.
Play with me, yes. Khadija.
We have carrot cake, and the carrot cake is carrot, pineapple, and nuts.
They were supposed to bring for us, but they didn't bring it. I'm going to throw it out there.
And,
we'll have yours packaged and ready.
I'm looking forward to that. And I love the idea. Mm-hmm. We're having these free services. We're having entertainment. We're going to be mm-hmm. having all these women feature mm-hmm. their businesses too as
mm-hmm.
well.
Mm-hmm.
And what I have to say I've appreciated is so much that sometimes people don't understand what Islam is about. And it's mm-hmm. a great time to just ask mm-hmm. questions.
Right.
That's a good point, because we also have some informative displays there. We have, we're going to have a try a hijab style.
Ooh, again, so, yes. I remember you had that last time too as well.
Yes,
it was really cool to ask questions about that.
And
too.
You get a free hijab.
Oh, really?
Come and try on a hijab. Mm-hmm. So, you know, you get
try
to understand.
Free.
You know, the thing is, in life, you know, Belize is multicultural.
Yes.
And, you know, there's many different religions here. Mm-hmm. And our community have always been one to integrate ourselves in the community. Once a year, every year, because we do things annually.
Yeah.
Yes, of
okay?
course.
We have an interreligious conference, and we invite the Buddhists, we invite Christian, Hindu, Rasta. Let us come together and see what our commonality
That's
is.
Beautiful.
Because we have more commonality than we have difference.
Mm-hmm.
Plus, the fact is, when you don't know someone, you build up a lot of sometimes animosity.
Yeah, that's so true.
You know, and you make these bad assumptions. So when you come on Saturday, we're inviting all the women in Belize to come, try on a hijab, you know, ask questions if you want to ask questions. It's okay, you know, and it's a safe place for women.
Yeah, I always tell my friends, you know, the crazier the questions, the better, because I'm a convert. So my friends, they have questions. The crazier, the better, because I definitely need to go and go and explain whatever, misconception there is about Islam, because there's a lot. And so we really hope to, bring your questions. We're going to have books. We're going to have pamphlets. We're going to have the try hijab style, yes. Mm-hmm. And of course, we're going to have that sisterhood that we want to build. We also have a...
We're going to have
a clothing sale. Okay. Really, really affordable clothing. Dirt cheap, come out.
Girl, we love a dirt cheap.
Yes.
Come
and
out.
And while it's exclusive to women.
Yeah, which is good because we need spaces that are exclusively for women.
Thank you, Kyle.
Yes,
that's true. While it's exclusive, send your representative. You send them, let them bring you back some food. Let them pick you up some clothes because there will be clothes available for men and boys. Send your representative and we'll take care of them.
I'm representing myself and Philip. I'm going to take back some carrot cake from my husband.
Exactly.
One important, very important thing that we're doing, this year, we have the problem in Palestine and Gaza. So some of the funds that we raise will be directed to them.
Oh, because I love
it's
that.
Yes. So come and help the this effort of ours, and learn something about Islam and Muslims, I'm a convert too. Okay. Although I converted a long time ago before. You don't reset, but don't I'm a long
time ago. Don't put me out like that.
So but nonetheless, it's just a religion. Islam means peace. Mm-hmm. And our community, our motto is love for all, hatred for none.
I love it.
That's right.
We're rooted in peace, compassion, and service to humanity.
Yeah. I know the service part is really important too, because
important.
That is something that is embedded in how you carry out your day-to-day activities too.
Definitely. Right. It's a lifestyle, really.
It's at Masjid Noor, which is at 1.5 miles on the George Price Highway. Mm-hmm. I don't have her number.
It is the number to call if you're interested, if you have any questions, if you want to have a stall, we're still welcoming.
Oh, nice.
You could call 615-2648. I think we have it on the flyer.
615-2648. 2648 for our television people.
Yes.
Folks on Facebook, and, it's right there.
Yeah, so it's tomorrow. 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. Come out at the mosque. Bring your questions. Bring your hungry bellies. We're ready to serve.
Bring
you.
Your money.
Yes.
That's right.
Bring your money.
Yes.
And also bring an open mind. I think that's super important too as well. Think of it as a place where you can ask questions, be around another amazing woman, and just be and have that time to unwind and learn from each other and probably fill into each other's cups too as well.
Yes.
So I think that's really important.
That's what we hope. That it's an open dialogue. It's an understanding that's going to take place. It's an experience.
You can't experience it if you ain't come out. So come out, guys.
Thank you so much
for all the incredible work that you guys are doing to make sure that women can come together and, be in these spaces. So
right. I understand at the World Cup, the recent World Cup, mm-hmm. they had it so that it was only no alcohol, and everything went so smoothly.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, that's interesting.
So some of the things that we bring to the table is beneficial to the society.
Yeah,
exactly.
Because we do believe that every commandment that we got from God, he knows us best. He created us. Yeah. So he knows best as to how we should live our lives. So come out, ask your questions, come and get comfortable.
Come and get comfortable, guys. Kick off your shoes. And come out and enjoy.
And we also have a space for children.
That's what I wanted to say. So we're going to have a play zone for kids. We're going to have a bouncy house. So if there are any moms attending, you can unwind while your kid, they have their experience of their own. So come out.
As well.
Of course, right. Okay. So really, there's something for everyone. Remember.
There's excitement brewing.
Yeah. Send your representative men. Send your representatives.
Send your representative. I love that
something
word.
Something for everyone.
Send your representative.
Yeah.
Mr. Sean, I want to say thank you so much for joining us. It's Friday on Sunup on 7.
Thank you for having us.
Once more,
really
happy Women's Day.
Thank you.
Let's celebrate diversity of women. Let's celebrate the accomplishment.
That's right.
Long way that, the journey, because we would be nowhere without women.
So that's right.
Let's celebrate women.
It took me nine months to have my son.
There you go.
Let them know. Yes.
That's right. Folks, with that, we're going to go on our next commercial break. When we're back, we have a giveaway for you.
Excitement.
So get those fingers ready.
All right.
We'll be right back.
Yeah.
up to positivity and inspiration. It's a fresh and diverse twist on your mornings. Tune in to Sunup on 7 every weekday morning at 6:30 a.m. right here on your nation station, Channel 7. It's the morning show you don't want to miss.
We have delicious pizzas from 4 to 12 slices. Pepperoni, Hawaiian, meat lovers, Mexican pizza, and full house supreme pizza. Wings from 10 pieces up in regular and spicy barbecue. Honey mustard, chipotle, garlic parmesan, tangy barbecue, spicy buffalo, and lemon pepper. Delivery also available. Call 620-9805 to order.
Buy me one caro consomme.
Caro consomme. Caro. Mr. Shan, Mr. Shan, give me a...
You want egg?
Uh-uh.
Oh, you want consomme.
Caro consomme.
Caro consomme. The best taste and the best price. Less fat, more flavor. Caro consomme. Available in packets for only 20 cents and a half-pound jar for only $2.75. Less fat, more flavor, more savings.
Give me a...
Caro consomme.
Taste the savings. Love the flavor.
Two teams fighting for position. Two teams fighting for a city. Only one can prevent.
Defenders don't frighten of nobody.
Police City, your high-octane, sharp-shooting, high-flying Police City Defenders returns home, boasting a 4-0 record. And are hoping and eager to serve up a loss to their intercity rivals, the Venice Hurricanes. Muy Uno Resort and Old Capital Sports get set to bring the biggest Friday Night Lights episode of this 2024 BEPL season. And it goes down this Friday, March 8th, inside the Police City Civic Center. Fans, look out for major giveaways like resort stays courtesy Muy Uno and our big halftime 1-2-3 Cooking Oil Challenge for not one, not two, not three, but $4,000 in whole hard cash. Don't miss it! Sponsors!
Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
Can you produce your driver's license, please?
Sure, no problem.
Okay, Mr. Vernon, it's valid.
Thank you.
Mr. Vernon, did you know your insurance will be up tomorrow?
Oh, really?
Make sure you try to update your policy, please.
Thanks so much for the heads up.
Babe, can you please renew my policy?
We know that you get caught up in life sometimes, which is why RFNG Insurance makes renewing your insurance policy easy with WhatsApp. Just WhatsApp the words "get started" to 670-8700. We will prompt you to select the service you are interested in. Select the service and answer a few simple questions. An RFNG representative will process your request and follow up with you when your transaction is completed. It's that easy. Use WhatsApp and skip the lines. Remember, it pays to get it right with RFNG Insurance, a Roe Group company.
Tenemos la capacidad técnica, operativa, profesional y la infraestructura de poder establecer una atención neurológica de alta calidad.
Que no se pierda tiempo de forma innecesaria para poder al final del día llegar al mejor de los resultados y la mejor opción para el paciente.
We have delicious pizzas from 4 to 12 slices. Pepperoni, Hawaiian, meat lovers, Mexican pizza, and full house supreme pizza. Wings from 10 pieces up in regular and spicy barbecue. Honey mustard, chipotle, garlic parmesan, tangy barbecue, spicy buffalo, and lemon pepper. Delivery also available. Call 620-9805 to order.
Wake up to positivity and inspiration. It's a fresh and diverse twist on your mornings. Tune in to Sunup on 7 every weekday morning at 6:30 a.m. right here on your nation station, Channel 7. It's the morning show you don't want to miss.
Take a minute. Imagine yourself in that long road trip in that dream vehicle. Right now, that dream may seem a bit far-fetched, but with Real Deal Auto Sales, that dream can be realized. We not only have quality and reliable vehicles, but affordable vehicles. Did someone say layaway? Yes! Call us today at 613-1889 to ask about our layaway plans or visit us at 2736 Hummingbird Highway, Belmopan, right across from the showgrounds. Be a boss with Real Deal Auto Sales.
And we're back on Sunup on 7. It's Friday. Like we told you, we have an exciting giveaway courtesy of women that are participating in entrepreneurship. The giveaway is one small bottle of sangria by Sangria Mia. We have one small grazing board by I Love Grazing Boards. And one dessert courtesy of Kisses and Bites.
Yummy!
Folks, the question for you to win this giveaway if you're on our Facebook Live is, name four persons working on Wednesday's heat check. So we want one host, one reporter, and two technical team members.
Ooh, and we listed out a lot yesterday when we thanked the crew. We listed out some today too as well. It was a lot of people we listed. So if you don't know, or no better know.
Mm-hmm.
Man,
if
like
you
this.
No better know, I love it. I love it. So let me repeat. So in your answer, you have to put four names. You have to have one host, one reporter, and two technical team members. So that can include directors, sound engineer, videographer, persons working in the control room. We're gonna wait for that answer. While we wait for you to put that answer on the Facebook live chat, we have some very cool footage. So let me repeat it. We have one host, one reporter, and two technical team members. So it's four names that are supposed to go in the chat. Put all of them together for you to be able to be the lucky winner of one small bottle of sangria by Sangria Mia, one small grazing board by I Love Grazing Boards, and one dessert by Kisses and Bites.
Ooh. I'm so excited because it's a really amazing package for them, as well as it's by all female entrepreneurs, ladypreneurs, and they're doing this exceptional stuff. I think you guys saw the video just now where they're doing the 360 camera dancing with their stuff. They're going to be out at Kisses and Bites Fest on St. Thomas, and they're going to be out there from 3 p.m., to 7 p.m. They're having a big shigmading where you can just come out and support these women while they have their merchandise out there, their products out there. So please stop by and taste and enjoy and pick up something for me. Pick up something for yourself and treat yourself, Boozilla, because you deserve good things, especially in honor of International Women's Day. Women, I really want to encourage you to go out there and buy yourself something nice, man.
Support each other too.
Support, exactly. Mm. Women supporting other women. Female empowerment, I'm here for it all day long.
That's true, because the big advocacy for this year is two things. It's economic disempowerment of women, and the next one is advocating for the reproductive rights of women. So that's what's getting celebrated as we talk about inspire inclusion, invest in women, accelerate programs.
Mm.
What's exciting about this weekend, Ren, is that it's Ruta Maya weekend.
Ruta Maya!
And of course, we support our very own Brandon and his team, Life Happy Live, and we have some footage to share with you about how they're doing out there in this river.
Has the boat turned over?
Has the boat turned over?
Stay
tuned
for the
video. But we do have this video to show of how it's
going
out there.
I want to announce the video like news as we're reporting live here.
There we go.
From Sunup on 7, we have some video footage presently of Brandon, Life Half a Live team at La Ruta Maya.
So there goes Brandon and his team.
They just put the thing on and even allow me to continue and announce it.
Continue.
You see? I don't want to announce it again. I don't salty.
You don't salty.
I don't salty. I don't but upset. Folks, that's there, not why he got called victorious and this that way.
But there you go, folks. So that's Brandon and his team, Life Have a Live. Please put, you know, hashtag Life Have a Live on the group chat. Let's create some encouraging energy for him as he's out there. We hope that they make it all the best. All right, so we hope our control room is helping us to peruse who is the winner of this giveaway. Again, you have to mention four names, which includes one host, one reporter, and two technical team members.
So four no, Miss Arlette, you gave room. More hosts than anything else. I'm checking here. Miss Serena says, no, you gave two hosts and two reporters. Guys, one host. That means one person that was on this table here talking for the period of time, giving the heat check for you. The reporters are the people that we went to videos that they were reporting on the stories that were out there, right? And then technical team are all the people you don't get to see, but they're making sure the ship is running smoothly, sailing across in the best waters.
I didn't mention my technical team support.
You mentioned your technical team support. We had bigged up some of the guys yesterday too as well, because they were working early shift yesterday morning, with Sunup, late shift the night for heat check, all of that too as well. And I think they also were doing early shift too as well for heat check throughout the day. So
all right, so we have Michelle Sampson. Sapna, can you let us know if that's the most recent chat? Because
That correct?
All right, so Michelle Sampson won.
Michelle,
the host, one of the hosts was Miriam, of course. Good job, Miriam. Yeah. The next reporter was Kevin. I was out there at Orange Walk, and technical team Victor and Cody.
Yep.
Michelle, good job.
We had several hosts. We had Moose, we had Indara, we had Jules, we had Brandon. They were all hosts out there making, Miriam, they were all making sure that you guys had the scoop. Reporters were Courtney, we had Kev, we had Miss Katie, we had so much people.
Joe Marie,
one with the Altina Carrazal that lived her very best life. But we had a lot of them, and then of course tech support. We talked about Vic Cordell. Cody. My goodness, Brian. We had Rydell. Because I thought I put Cody and Rydell together, I make a whole new person. That's the way I do. But we had a lot of people. We had Ronnie too as well. We have to big up for audio and these different things too. We had Mike. So big up to everybody that was out there. I know I'm missing names. Denver, so much people. Glenn, so much people out there.
Yes.
Big up to people. So,
elections watch. Heat check was one for the
books. Heat check. We're not going to be having this set anymore. Tuesday when we come back, it's going to be different, guys. So
gonna go back to our usual space.
So say goodbye to it. Let's say goodbye.
But of course, we gotta like big up once more Gilvana for doing this amazing.
Yes.
Amazing. Oh
yes.
Right there.
Dickie too as well. Yes. I think Dickie was one of the hosts.
Yeah, he was.
I was wondering if he was a host or a panelist, man.
He was a panelist.
I think panelist. That's why I never mentioned.
Yes.
Oh. Wow. Them getting when I'm really deep in focus.
Yeah, Renata was very deep in her crochet.
Wow.
Oh, what?
Wow.
What is this about? Are we doing a throwback? Renata, look at you.
Wow. That was actually from Adele, her hat. She knitted the hat. And then the little thing for the teddy bear. She did all that. She does cute fashion for animals, for your fur babies. So
okay. So, Michelle, you won the giveaway today.
You have to go pick it up.
At Kisses and Bites between 3 and...
7 p.m.
7 p.m. So... We're winding down today's show, Bren.
We wind down today's
time
show.
For us to wrap
I do
up.
Also want to remind you guys that Miss World Belize, Miss Elise Vernon is out there. She's doing amazing things. I was actually following Miss Karen because Miss Karen is so sweet. She is really so supportive of her family and showing how Elise is turning heads. Like she's in top 21s and top 10s and all these different
Very
things.
Good.
With just the preliminary rounds, and people are seeing her and noticing how much, you know, oof, and Judge she brings to the table. So tomorrow is actually the premiere of the Miss World pageant. It's going to be starting at Belize 8 a.m. time, and they actually start on correct time. So please remember that too as well. So tune in. You can also follow Elise's page on Facebook and Instagram to see updates of her with the ladies and all the practice they're putting in. Or you can follow Miss Karen Vernon because she posts up everything too as well. It's like she keeps her quite in tune with everything what happened. But please support her. She's really doing an exceptional job out there. proud of her and everything that she's doing right now for us. So, just want to remind you of that.
It's time for us to say goodbye. We want to wish you a safe and enjoyable weekend if you're going to go out there in the Rutamaya. Please stay hydrated. Remember to pack your garbage and not leave your garbage out there.
Thank
the point
you.
Of Rutamaya is to show the awareness for conservation of the riparian forest. So let's do that. We wish Brandon and his team all the best, all teams competing. Wish you a safe and an enjoyable time. We'll be back on Tuesday because Brandon will need a day to recover. So yeah. Renata and I are going to join you on Tuesday with some great footage of what happened in Rutamaya. And of course, more exciting stuff on Sunup on 7.
Yeah, we want to thank all our guests that came out today. Thank you so much for Adele showing us how to do crocheting, bring back memories for Kevito and bring me so much focus, if you would only understand. We want to thank Dee's Dance Studio and the amazing young people for Child Stimulation Month. They were giving us respect in every single way, shape, and form. I loved their piece. And of course, we had the women from the Amadea women's group that was in. They have their international expo for women tomorrow at the mosque. So come out and support them. Enjoy and have a safe weekend, guys. We're going to see you back here Tuesday. Drink your water and mind your own business. Kidney stones, they both.
Yes. It's also Kidney Awareness Month.
Exactly.
Yeah, much kind of thing. Bye, folks.
I feel
we love
exhausted.
You.
By me and we'll take flight. We'll be there at morning's light. I've got you covered on all concerns we share today. You will discover how the world turns each day. When the sun comes up,